Hello, I'm Jeff Jacoby, Beca professor and executive producer of BECAfest, the show you're about to see. The students putting all this together had an amazing show planned for tonight. Big audience, live TV broadcast, laughter, tears, the whole ginormous, beautiful deal. But if you haven't noticed, there's a global pandemic going on in the year 2020. I mean, you have noticed that, right? When the SF State campus closed down, so did all the student facilities. They lost access to the TV and sound studios, portable equipment, the prop shop, editing room, radio studios, even their friends and professors. Every damn thing. We all wanted to quit. We wanted to cry, and trust me, we cried. So the fate of BECAfest 2020 was left in the hands of this stupid COVID virus. But the show must go on. We're gonna put on our annual show that celebrates the superb work of BECA students. And the acceptance speeches, by the way, are all being streamed live. And it's gonna be great. I hope. So relax, grab a snack or some such, and welcome to BECAfest 2020.
Once upon a time, in the long-lost kingdom of the Beca department, there was an evil witch that hated bad acting.
I shall turn you into a toad.
So she used her powers to conjure a dragon that would terrorize the kingdom. And only the best on-air talent, armed with the holy Becky, could slay the dragon and return peace to the land. It was a gruesome battle, but three valiant knights survived. Now the question is, who will retrieve the holy Becky, slay the dragon, and save the kingdom using the power of acting?
I'm here at Ceremony Shopping Center in Daly City, and as you can see, the parking lot is fairly empty, which is definitely not normal for a Tuesday afternoon. And as coronavirus numbers continue to rise, it seems as people are avoiding crowded spaces.
With graduation being such a special event to, like as you said, celebrate all your accomplishments, how do you feel not knowing whether your university will give you the opportunity to walk the stage?
Festivities are underway as San Francisco celebrates its 37th annual Fleet Week. Thousands are expected to come into the city to enjoy the many attractions Fleet Week has to offer. Thanksgiving is right around the corner, and if you have a hard time getting your turkey just right, you're not the only one.
Unfortunately, I think it might be done when I graduate, but I'm still excited to be a part of it.
As the nation continues to fight the COVID-19 pandemic, we are very grateful for all the workers on the front line who go out every day risking their health to keep us safe. Reporting from home, I'm Natasha Cassino for State of Events. The pandemic has disrupted what our day-to-day looks like, resulting in changes on how we're spending money. So what would it be like to be in the shoes of a local coffee shop owner during these times? Our State of Events reporter Juan Lopez has more on the story.
For the first edition of What's Up Bay Area, I'll be giving you the deets about some cool and affordable events happening this weekend in the Bay. If you like boba, museums, and alcohol specials, well then, you're in luck. This weekend, not one, not two, but three museums will have free admission for Bay Area residents.
Time flies when you're counting down the days for your next vacation. If you're looking to escape the Castro and find a place surrounded by palm trees, an ocean breeze, and a place known for its gorgeous weather, then let's head on over to Strut, a new LGBTQ bar in Orange County, California. This venue is tailored for the millennium generation. With every surface being photographable, it ends up being social media savvy, leaving your newest Insta pics with a wow. So if you're ever in Orange County, stop by this all-inclusive playground filled with savvy queers, trendy ladies, sexy surfers, and every self-expression in between. In Costa Mesa, I'm Eduardo Wijon, State of Events.
With the rising cost of housing and lack of availability in the city, students at San Francisco State are struggling to find a place to stay and have nowhere else to turn other than their vehicles.
Today's event was filled with Broadway performances, drag queens, and all-around family fun. This is a great addition to San Francisco's Union Square, and everyone should check it out if they have the time.
I'm Bronte Sorotsky for State of Events, and I'm here at Jolene's in San Francisco to give you the inside scoop on San Francisco's drag queen scene.
Registering for the drive is quick and painless. A few seconds of your life can give someone a second chance at theirs.
Apple is telling Genius Bar employees to prepare for iPhone shortages. All thanks to the coronavirus.
Yesterday, students living on campus at SF State received a worrying email that by Monday, they could be homeless. It now seems that isn't the case.
I'm Bronte Sorotsky for State of Events, and right now I am live at Malcolm X Plaza. Normally this area is full of students walking around, eating, tabling, and now it is almost completely empty.
Verdict has been reached in the Harvey Weinstein rape trial. The disgraced former Hollywood producer was found guilty on two counts, on criminal sexual act assault and rape in the third degree. He's been found not guilty on two of his most serious charges, predatory sexual assault and rape in the first degree. The University of Southern California says, as of last Thursday, families with an annual income of $80,000 or less are able to attend the university tuition-free.
Hello. My name is Professor Dina Ibrahim, and I'm here to announce the winner in Video Best Talent. And the winner is Natasha Cassino. Congratulations, Natasha.
Wow. Thank you, guys. Thank you so much to the judges. Thank you so much to Professor Dina Ibrahim and Andy Pittman, who were my professors for State of Events. You guys really helped me with my on-camera presence, and you guys really helped me with my academic career. And just you always were there to lend a helping hand, whether it be helping me with my resume or checking my reel or even just talking about the future of jobs. And I just thank you guys so much. I couldn't have done this without you guys. Thank you so much.
Okay, why am I here?
We gotta film the package.
Film what?
Just talk about
there's
shit.
There's nothing here, William.
Just make something up.
You see, there's nobody here, which is what's supposed to happen. Nobody's supposed to be here.
Talk about the pretty
flowers.
We're
not supposed to be here.
What
am I gonna
flowers?
Talk about flowers
They're very
for?
Yellow.
Does this look yellow to you?
It looks extreme
This
yellow.
Does not you look yellow.
Is that a sunflower?
It looks like it died yesterday.
You look like you died yesterday.
You know what? Okay. Hi, I'm Edwin Herrera, and I'm here at this empty San Francisco State University where many students are being denied an education due to COVID-19. And nobody's supposed to be here. Wait, there's someone there. Hey, you! You! Hey! Hey!
You know what? Get out! Let's go
Pull yourself together, get yourself together. We got a show to do.
Okay, thank you for joining us here at Losing It News, where I'm losing it big time. My name's Cameron Patera, and I'll be your lead anchor. Our top story tonight, I was on Twitter the other day, and apparently there's this thing that's plaguing the entire world. It's called No, that's not right. Sound it out. C-O-R, coronavirus. And frankly, it's got us a little scared, a little worried over here at the Patera Studio. I don't know where it came from. You don't know where it came from. You definitely don't know. And before you go out and do your own research, I've brought an expert on to help quell your anxieties. Grammy-nominated singer-songwriter Cameron Patera, welcome.
Thanks, Cam. Glad to be here. I'm not exactly a medical expert, but I do consider myself a philanthropist. I've been donating bags of rice, not the good ones, don't worry, to affected communities.
Wow, Mr. Patera, that's very noble of you. I can't say that I've ever considered donating to people less fortunate than me.
You're welcome.
Let's move away from this drab and dreary. You got any music coming
I'll
out?
I'll actually be on Instagram Live tomorrow, where I'll be performing my anti-coronavirus anthem.
An anti-coronavirus anthem? Well, what does that sound like? Can you give us a little preview, a little sneak peek?
A friend is blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind.
Wow, that was beautiful. I love Bob Dylan.
Who's Bob Dylan?
Streaming services provide digital distribution of videos and music via the internet. The 2000s saw this with YouTube and iTunes. Television streaming is today's popular form of multimedia, especially for one demographic.
I use Netflix for more like binge-watching TV shows and YouTube for like just watching videos on BART or anything.
That demographic is young adults. A 2017 Pew Research shows 18 to 29-year-olds use streaming services the most compared to other demographics. College students are one of the top consumers of television streaming services.
My roommates and I have like an Amazon Fire Stick. So we have all of our streaming services on there.
Streaming services like Netflix, Hulu, and Amazon Prime provide a wide variety of television shows at the click of a button or at the tap of a phone. Customers can watch shows on their smart TV, laptop, phone, or tablet. They are in control on choosing what to watch and where to watch whenever they please.
It's the replayability and just having like a constant stream of, oh, I want to see the next episode. Oh.
Streaming services are easily accessible and convenient. However, cable television isn't. This leads to consumers cutting the cord. Cord cutting means getting rid of cable and switching to streaming.
The Bachelor, I don't have time to watch it when it's on TV, so I can watch it the next day on Hulu.
Yes, streaming services are accessible and convenient, but how much are the streaming services costing customers, especially customers that own more than one service? According to PC Mag, 40% of consumers say they are willing to pay up to $20 for all streaming services combined.
The White House administration needs to regulate and limit how the corporations operate because the climate change they created is threatening not only my nation, the Kingdom of Tonga, but also throughout Oceania as a whole.
With a huge crowd in support of Climate Action Week, students like Andrew Vyatt shared with State of Events the negative impacts of climate change affecting our environment and for some even in their own homes.
Like erosion, right? Waves crashing on the land, breaking pieces of the land off little by little. Acidity in the ocean temperature, you know what I'm saying? So coral reefs are being destroyed because of the change of the temperature of the water. And as we speak right now in many islands in the Pacific, like waves are getting closer and closer to people's backyards, to people's front of their houses. It's a reality for folks in Oceania. And if you just Google and search those islands and climate change, you will see that this is a reality for them.
Hello, everyone. I'm Professor Larson. I hope you all are doing well and staying safe, and I can't wait until I can see you again face to face. The winning show for video, best news or sports package is State of Events Streaming. Congratulations.
Okay, wow, I'm kind of surprised. Everyone did such amazing packages. Congrats to also all the nominees. You guys did amazing. I want to thank Andy Pittman for kind of pushing me to do a package outside of my comfort zone. Fall semester, I was in State of Events and my beat was entertainment. So I would do obviously entertainment news, and he kind of pushed me to do something a little bit more relating back to the students, but also having an entertainment aspect. So I want to give a big shout out to Andy Pittman and also a big shout out to everyone else who I interviewed during this. And yeah.
You're watching the TV and video fiction category on BECAfest 2020. We'll be right back.
Lights, camera, action!
Write your script, build your set, record your project. Produce the films you've only ever dreamed of with the Studio Toy Set. Revise your script. Send PAs to do tasks you don't want to do.
It's
It's just like the real thing.
Without all the stress.
Yeah.
Finalize your script, finish it in post, or say screw it, and just do it live. Become a real-life movie producer and get yourself ready for the big time with the Studio Toy Set.
Sets, actors, and crew sold separately.
Welcome back to BECAfest 2020. Now for the nominees for the TV and video fiction category.
Hi, Ari on the air here. Are you having a hard time dating? Are you struggling sharing your experience with others? Have you been abducted by aliens? Well, struggle no more with abductedbylove.com. This is real. Creating a profile will take less than your abduction. Just put in your name, location, and social security and start searching for your perfectly sane lover. Just listen to these testimonials that I'm not paid enough to read. 28-year-old Skylar says, "Logging onto this website was the best decision of my life. Within weeks, I found the perfect human companion. We're soon having a marriage ceremony." 46-year-old Linda says, "The dating life was hard for me. No humans believed my traumatizing story. I wasn't until website abductedbylove.com where I found the correct spouse." I guess Grammar also got abducted. I can thank abductedbylove.com for producing my spawn. I am now a happy father of two cis 35-year-old Jimothy. Okay, cut. Jesus Christ, it sounds like an actual alien wrote these. Who emailed you about this?
They just sent us 6.72 Bitcoin and told us not to ask questions.
What's that in US dollar? With 12 easy payments of $42, you can be invaded with love. That's abductedbylove.com. Jesus Christ.
Come on,
Hey girl, this is Dr. Chris Clemens. You know, as a judge on RuPaul's Drag Race under my stage name, Michelle Visage, I can say that the directors and producers in the Video Best Fiction category have sashayed their way into our hearts with their charisma, uniqueness, nerve, and talent. I could not be prouder of all the work that Beca students have done. The winner of the Video Best Fiction category is... I'm so excited. Oh, it's Parallel World. Yes! Work that runway, yes, please.
I'm here to say thank you to Cineworld, our film crew, and I know it's really tough time for everyone during this pandemic, but I hope everyone can overcome it in their own way without being bored like this. Right. Thank you.
All right, everyone. Listen up. Jeff has gathered us all here today because we are the greatest minds in Beca, and he needs us now more than ever to come up with an intro to the nonfiction category of BECAfest. Now, listen, I'm really counting on you guys here. Gabby, what do you got for me?
I don't know.
Edwin, I know you got something for me, man. What you got?
Bro, you wanna see how fast I can chug this White Claw in this shot?
Edwin, it's 10 a.m.
That's your nonfiction right there!
Will? Will. Will.
Oh, yo.
No, I don't have anything.
Steph, anything?
Bound 2 remake. You, Kim, me, Kanye, on a bike, green screen, wind, landscape, beautiful. It would be so good. Captivating.
You guys are a f***ing joke.
Okay, guys, now that he's gone, here's an idea.
The Sinulog Festival in Cebu. That is in the middle part of the Philippines in the Visayan Islands. I've never been there, it's my first time. And I've heard of the Sinulog Festival, which is supposed to be the largest religious festival in the Philippines. It's Roman Catholic. Dance is a big part of the festival. They actually have competitions. Barangays, or sections of towns, would compete against each other to do this dance in honor of baby Jesus. And it's like dozens and dozens of dancers per group, per se. And it's amazing, and it's the steps are pretty much what you see in Philippine folk dance, especially the Spanish-derived ones. To see how folk dance has evolved into this mega, mega performances and choreographies.
I started with one knot on the wall and would just nail each new day's knot next to it in a way that looks like a constantly growing amoeba. The shape is organic, and that's a reflection of the process. The process was organic. It was one knot every day. It grew slowly and intentionally. Beyond the 366 knots that I learned how to call myself an artist and give myself the confidence to say that creativity is the most important thing in my life. I was really happy when Facebook asked me to create a second edition of the Year of Knots for their offices because I want as many people as possible to see the work and to get to love the beauty of knots. For any given situation, there's a knot that's right and all the other knots are wrong, and you don't know that until you're familiar enough with the knots. And then once you figure it out and understand them, they're all within your grasp. In order to see the beauty of the knot, you just need to see it as clearly as possible. They are beautiful objects and don't need extra decoration in order to be amazing, beautifully engineered, intelligent objects. The more that I can do to help people see the beauty of knots, just in their simplicity alone and their construction and the beauty in that, the happier I am.
Professor Piriai. So, the winner for best video nonfiction is Wendy Chen, fiber artist. Congratulations.
Thank you for the nomination. I appreciate it. And I want to say thanks to my parents and my grandparents and all my family. I love you guys. I miss you guys. Also, my professors from the last year, Joel Wanick, and especially Jeff Jacoby for pushing me out of my comfort zone. So I appreciate this very much. Thank you.
Do you want to start drinking? I know that it is only noon, but we don't really have to go to work, and there is literally nothing else to do. I know this was a present, and I googled this wine, and it's only worth $4. Do you want to start drinking? Are you not thinking what I'm thinking? Not so much.
Don't let TikTok consume your life. This has been a public service announcement for everyone dealing with a loved one who can't stop using TikTok. Now here are the nominees for Best PSA Commercials.
For years, the Bay has been a hub for greatness. Here at San Francisco State University, we are blessed to be in the ultimate city. Rooted in a community with such resilience and creativity, there is no battle the Bay backs down from. But it's time for a new challenge. On a stage to show the world what you got. Let's play some f***ing Smash.
3, 2, 1, go!
You want to introduce yourself to everybody?
Oh, that's a good idea. You know, I should do that. Yep. Hi, my name is Mike. I'm here in the studio. I'm all mic'd up because it's my segment. It's what I do here, all mic'd up.
So what's your position in the class?
I just told you, all mic'd up.
I'm Katya Vogt. I'm the second TD, technical director, switcher, whatever you'd like to call it.
Are you enjoying the class so far?
I really am, yeah. I really like the professional atmosphere. The crew is great. Both classes are amazing. Everyone's working together really well. Everyone takes it seriously. They're super professional. I love it. Here, I'm just the second TD, so I switch off with the other one. Every week, we do different.
Nice. Would you recommend this class to any other students that are thinking about taking it?
Absolutely. It is the best way to get experience without being pressured into having to get an actual job, but still have that professional environment and still feel like you are getting experience like you would get on an actual set, for sure. And everyone's learning at the same time, so it's not like you have to prove yourself constantly because everyone's on the same level.
Hey, have you seen my coffee? I always leave it in the microwave.
You wanna play it? So that's why.
Ah, nature. Oh, an explorer, eh? I wonder what they're looking for. Snack time. Now back to business, eh? Could it be our explorer has found something? What could it be? Crikey! It's the nominees for Best TV Video, Experimental.
Let's go!
Alright, fine. Ring, ring.
Hello?
Hello, this is Dwight Schrute from the Dunder Mifflin Paper Company.
Wow, that's great, because I need paper.
Excellent, then you are in luck, because we are having a limited time offer only on everything.
Wow, this is my lucky day.
Ask him his name. What is your name, sir?
I am Bill Buttlicker.
Really, that's your real name?
How dare you? My family built this country, by the way.
Be respectful, Dwight, please.
Yes, Michael.
to help me with some schoolwork, all right? And to record an interview, you know? Come on,
no,
please.
Stop.
Come on. Come on. Let's do it. All right, we're just gonna, you know, ask some questions. Ask some questions for an interview we have to do. All right? Just some basic questions, you know? Just some basic, like, you know, how you doing? Anime. All those type of questions, okay? So, question one. What have you been doing during these bizarre times? You know, I know other people have other ways of dealing with the quarantine. But how have you been experiencing it? What have you been doing in the meantime? Now, honestly, I haven't been doing, you know, anything at all. Not really, just you know, just the basic things like eating, sleeping, bathroom, you know, gaming, and the occasional homework, you know?
Hi, my name is Sam. I'm 40.
The winner of Best Experimental Video is...
Pie.
No.
Orange.
Orange.
Video.
Goodbye.
Now can I have the chocolate banana?
I just want to thank my roommates. They helped me out when I was making this, and I had a lot of fun. It's for a class project, and I'm honored that it won. Thanks a lot.
Hello.
Hey, guys.
Yo, thanks for inviting us.
Yeah, you guys, thank you guys for showing up. I thought we could use a hangout and have a Zoom party.
What are we going to do, though? I got a drink and snacks.
Ooh, me too. Cheers.
Ooh, kanpai. Yeah, let's do that new thing where you can share screen and watch Netflix together.
Or we could listen to music and chill.
Yeah, we can do that. Or we can watch this.
Wait, what's this?
Didn't you guys remember? It's BECAfest.
What? I thought they weren't going to do that this year.
Haven't you guys been reading your Beca Blast?
What? Yeah, check your emails, dude.
All right. Well, what award are they going to give out right now?
I think they said it was going to be for, like, sound of picture, you know, stuff like sound effects and voiceover for movies and TV, something like that.
Ooh, yeah!
Okay, everyone, okay, be quiet. They're going to name the nominees.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome back to BECAfest 2020. Our next award to be presented in the audio category will be for Best Sound for Picture. Our dedicated nominees have worked tirelessly to produce the sounds and curate the music that perfectly captures and conveys what we see with our eyes, whether it's on the big screen or on your handheld devices. Here are the nominees for Best Sound for Picture.
Thank you.
난 자꾸 머말라 넌 웃음 웃어 너 없이 살 수 없어 가지가 말라고 저 힘껏 손을 뻗어 뻗어 봐서 검색해버리고 미친 달려도 도대체 아닐 뿐 그냥 날 태워줘
Hello everyone, I'm Professor Naidu, everybody knows me as Rajiv. The winning show in audio, Best Sound for Picture, is Wally and Eve. Congratulations.
Wow, thank you so much. My group did not expect to win, if not be nominated for this award, if we're going to be honest. But on behalf of my group mates, Jamie and Manny, we're very grateful that we've been selected for this award. It was definitely a challenge, given that we were lacking the resources for this project due to the current conditions with COVID-19. But overall, I feel that we as a group definitely gave this project our all anyway, and I'm just very thankful that it was given the recognition through this award. So once again, thank you so much.
That sounded a little sad, huh? This coronavirus gotta go, man. Missing my friends is making me make my music some type of way. It's a little sad. But what else is there to do to pass the time besides make music? At least in my opinion. My fellow music heads know what I'm talking about. Yeah, yeah, I see you out there. I see you. No, I'm just kidding. I don't see you. I'm recording this on my laptop. Anyways. Back to the show. Here are the nominees for Best Audio Music Production. Pulling me in. I don't know how much more I can take. Oh, either you go or you stay till my heart is made of plastic. Wait, I know you didn't mean it. Wait, I know you're just scared. But baby, my heart is breaking. I don't know how much more of this I can bear. Made a mistake.
Hi, I'm Professor John Barsotti, and I'm here to present the winner of the audio music production, Stuck in Cycle by Vanessa Vindell. Congratulations, Vanessa.
Hi, thank you to all the panelists and judges for voting for me. Thank you to the BECA department for putting on this great production, despite the circumstances we're in. And I also want to thank my professor, Rajiv Naidu, for encouraging us to submit our work. And congratulations to all the nominees, and thank you guys very much. Appreciate it.
Hi, everyone. This year was an interesting year, was it not? Now, at BECAfest 2020, we're excited to see the creative works of BECA students who have experimented with sound. Here is Audio Experimental.
I was wondering if you had a new pair of heels for me to buy, since mine are a bit out of service. Size 7, if I may ask?
But of course, please follow me. Are you looking for any particular style?
No, just something similar. Also, I'm in a bit of a rush for rehearsal, if it's not too much to ask.
No worries, madam. I have the perfect pair right here.
Thank you again. I'm off to rehearsal now.
Goodbye.
Betty leaves and gets into in her Uber, not knowing what's to come.
Better to break these heels in now than later. I'm here. Let's get the show on the road.
Ah, Betty, you've made it. Quickly, get into position so we can start.
Ready whenever you are, Maurice. The apple is in place.
All right. I'm ready. On the count of three. One, two, three. Betty?
I saw a car emitting smoke in the spotlight of a street lamp. I stood at my front gate, watching the smoke rise as a man leaned into the back seat of the car. I waited to see what happened. The man leaned out of the car, closed the door. He walked away smoking a cigarette. I walked into my house and then I heard sirens coming up the street. Siren after siren, car after car. until the block was tipped off. My roommates gathered downstairs to see what happened.
What happened? Did you see that? What's going on out there? Hey, what happened? Did you see that? What happened? Did you see
the detective asked if we saw anything.
Did you see what happened tonight?
What happened, we asked. There was a body on fire in the back seat, he said.
There's a body in the back seat.
Hello, I'm Vinay Srivastava, one of your Beca department professors. You may not recognize me due to my stay-in-place beard. I'm excited that after 30 years in Beca department, I'm finally doing something significant. It is my honor to present the Best Experimental Audio Award, and the winner is... Ask Me If I Care. Congratulations, and congratulations to all Beca Fest winners.
Wow. Thank you. Thank you. First off, I want to thank my family, my mother, my sister, and my father. I want to thank Marcus and Maylin. You two are the best friends in the world. I want to thank Chelsea. Without you, I wouldn't view sound the same way. I want to thank Jennifer Egan, who is the reason why I named my piece Ask Me If I Care, from one of the chapters in one of her novels. And I want to thank every sound music, experimental music artist that inspired me. Too many to name. And I want to shout out Kenneth and Azul, who I got nominated with last year, but we didn't win. We should have. I still remember you guys. And this one goes out to you guys. Thank you. Thank you.
Cool cats and kittens, you are listening to KSFS Radio San Francisco. Broadcasting to you live from San Francisco State College Department of Broadcast Communication Arts. I'm Abby Rowe.
And I'm Ringo Starship.
And here at the station, we're always embracing chaos.
That's right, Abby. Why, just a few years back, we had that Kessie fellow here doing his acid tests.
Oh man, that was the same night the Dead performed on campus, huh?
Right again, Abby. And to this day, we present listeners with only top quality content from shows like Making Love on Air,
The Heebie Jeebies,
Tea Time,
and Phantom of the Gloria,
and so many more.
And tonight, we're here to honor the best of the best.
So without further ado, these are the nominees for Best Radio Show or Podcast.
Welcome to another delightfully spooky episode of
Grim Creepers.
I'm Camille Hoffman.
I'm Inez Flores. Today we're talking about werewolves.
And I think it's about to get a little hairy.
Nothing you've ever seen has such blood-chilling savagery. Nothing you've ever conceived packs such a fine tingling jolt.
The process of transforming into a werewolf is called lycanthropy. Typically, the people accused of being werewolves were men, and it was considered a type of witchcraft.
Finally, men getting persecuted for practicing magic.
This is the gender revolution we need.
A master of witchcraft.
To become a werewolf, a witch or sorcerer had to make a pact with the devil. And in return for pledging themselves, the sorcerer would receive a girdle.
I'm sorry, girdle isn't scary. Girdle doesn't sound
It just sounds
scary.
Like a granny, like granny panties.
Welcome, welcome, always welcome. You're always welcome to join us here in the studio.
This is just the interlude.
Honestly. You cannot knock the hustle. It's out to build a vessel. I'ma build up the block. No, you can never stop.
know you can never stop. Keep going, don't ever stop. DESTSOUTHAALA in the bay. Welcome to the interlude.
We got some messages coming in on the chat. This person, whoever you are, says you need to play some Taylor Swift. So, you know what we're going to do? You're welcome. And that's enough of that. So now we're going to have some good music, and this one's for you, Kenny C out there. To be back, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Rock and Roll Resurrection. We had the week off last week for Thanksgiving. Sex on Air, they took our spot. But ladies and gentlemen, we are here, and we have two shows left.
Only two left.
That's it. My name is Brayden. I am joined by, of course, my partner.
Max Summers over here. How y'all doing tonight?
That's right. We got a great show. So today, because we only have two left, I think we got to do it today. We are doing our favorite songs of all time. So every week we hit you with some different. We've done soft rock, we've done metal, we've done the golden oldies. Now it's our turn.
Hey guys, it's Professor Elaine LeYoung, and I'm super excited to announce the winning show in radio, best show or podcast. And the winner is social distancing here. That's PG&E. Okay, go progressive. Ah, here we are. The winner is Grim Creepers. Congratulations! Woo!
Hi. Oh, okay. Thanks, guys. I'm on accepting this on behalf of my co-host Camille and I, and she's the real MVP. She's the sultry voice and curates the music of the show. So, and have to thank the entire staff at KSFS, all the managers that keep that.
We are experiencing technical difficulties. Give us just one moment and we'll have the show up and running again. Thank you so much for your patience.
Oh, hello. You caught me in the middle of arranging the background shot for a Zoom meeting tomorrow. In this day and age of restricted social interaction, how else are we supposed to let our friends and acquaintances know what we've been listening to, watching, and reading if we can no longer shoehorn it into everyday conversation?
Hey, bro, I hate to break it to you, but no one cares.
They don't care about this meticulously laid out representation of my interests?
Nope.
What about this copy of Infinite Jest that I've definitely read?
Sorry, but no.
Well then, this next category is for best radio commercial or PSA, and the nominees are...
Did you hear the latest tea about the Kardashians?
No.
What about the latest rap beef?
No.
Tell me you heard the latest Jonas Brothers single.
No.
You didn't hear? Keep up with the latest entertainment news and pop culture with the Tea Room 2.0. Listen every Monday from 4 to 6 p.m. only at becamedia.net/radio.
And an 81-point game!
It's your boy Miles, and welcome to Catch M Shoot.
Bryant leaves, falling away, puts it in!
Every Wednesday from 12 to 1 on KSFS Radio.
I can't believe how fast 20 years went by. I mean, this is crazy. I think the most important part is that we all stayed together throughout because we didn't run.
Well, thank you, Kobe Bryant, for all the good memories.
What can I say? Mamba out.
Hello, hello. Hey, what's up, everyone?
Hey, what's poppin', Bobas?
What's going on? This is Derek.
This is Steven.
It's Amory from The Boba Show.
And you're listening to The Boba Show.
Tune in to The Boba Show every Tuesday, where we highlight important local and international news surrounding popular culture, music, movies, television, food, and trends that surround the Asian American community.
Make sure to tune in every Tuesday.
Every Tuesdays from 12 to 1 p.m.
12 to 1 p.m.
on KSFS Radio.
Hi, Professor Miriam here.
with radio, best commercial, or PSA. The envelope, please. Oh, this is the census. No, it must be a different envelope. Well, this isn't it either, but it's a $25 gift card from health insurance. You must have another envelope. No, that's not even for me. No, that's not. Steve, this is yours. Xfinity. Don't you have another envelope? This is like to nobody. But well, we can't keep everybody waiting. Let's just see what it is. The Boba Show. Congrats. Yay.
What's poppin', Bobas? I just want to start by acknowledging the other nominees and their dedicated work towards Becca. Sorry, I wrote a script for this, did not expect it. I want to thank my fellow hosts, Amory and Steven, who helped me create the show. Though this pandemic has suspended many of our activities and time in the studio, it did not stop the creativity, clever thoughtfulness, and the wit we have in the, as a Becca major. We made it work. Thank you to our parents, family, friends, the faculty, SFSU. And as Amory, Steven, and I look forward to a different type of graduation, here's to the class of 2020. The show still goes on. Thank you from the Boba Show, hashtag Team Life.
How's it going, guys? Welcome back to my Twitch channel.
Wait,
you're
wait,
here with
dude, we're doing BECAfest.
Right.
Sorry. What's going on, guys? It's Alicia.
And it's Amory.
We're here to announce the next category for BECAfest 2020.
This one is for the best radio news or sports segment.
Let me ask you this, Amory. What stood out to you in the world of sport this year? I know it's hard. There was a lot of good stuff.
I would definitely have to say when the 49ers went to the Super Bowl. One of my favorites. What about you? What was your favorite moment in news this year?
Oh my gosh, so much stuff happened. But did you hear about what Trump said about injecting disinfectant into your blood? I mean, how could you be
breaking news, guys? This just in. Here are the nominees.
Welcome back to KSFS Radio, where the Bay comes to stay. I'm Annie Oakland, and today we're talking with you about an app called Citizen. Around noon last Saturday, over 2,000 people received a notification on their phone of a large tree suddenly falling into traffic. Small buzzes throughout the 0.5-mile radius brought recent developments, with details of what the emergency personnel knew, how many lanes the tree was blocking, and, most importantly, that no one was injured as a result of the fallen tree. This wave of communication wasn't provided by an emergency or news outlet's app, but instead by Citizen, a recently launched crime mapping app.
As you know, I am a huge basketball fan, and this season in particular was special and important to me for a bunch of reasons. Obviously, I can't shut up about it. Kobe Bryant's death, I know that happened like midway into the season, but that was just so, it shook my world and the world around me. And it was obviously a huge motivator for the Lakers team to win it all. But in terms of basketball, the Lakers haven't made the playoffs since Kobe Bryant willed them to a playoff spot. It was that infamous.
Most U.S. companies hire a vast number of newly graduated international students yearly, but fears of an impending recession are making it tough for postgraduate international students from Malaysia to find a job so they can remain in the United States, Nurilini Ahmad reports.
As if competing for a job with the locals isn't challenging enough, international students from Malaysia are struggling to find jobs while trying to obey shelter-in-place orders to avoid becoming sick from the highly contagious coronavirus.
Huh. Hey, what's up? Camacho, and you caught me. Here I am. Here in my apartment again, in my kitchen again, drinking a hot chocolate again. This is my life now. It's everything to me. And yeah, been wearing this bathrobe since March 7th, so you know, Who cares, though, because there's no one else here. So I'm just kind of shuffling around because Jeff Jacoby asked me to read something to someone about something. I don't know. So I came to my kitchen to kind of figure out what he's talking about. And there's this whole pile of things here. Just so, let's see what we got. Oh, my passport, which is good in case after the next election I need to leave the country. Yay. DMV registration, because nothing says drive like shelter in place. Jeez. What's this? I know it's been a while, but could it be? Let's see. I'm getting too old for this. Let's see. Ah! The winning show in radio, best news or sports program. Post-grad employment. Yay!
Hi. Oh my gosh, this is so amazing. Thank you so much, BECAfest community. I just want to thank you, Professor Yumi, for encouraging me to submit my work and also put myself out of my comfort zone. Also, big thank you to my fellow interviewees. Yeah, thank you for sharing your stories. It's such an important time to know about your situation. So yeah, thank you so much.
This script is so
deep.
On an emotional level.
I thought I'd never see you again.
It's you. You.
We've been trying to make it work for so long. I just don't know what to do.
The BECAfest script might have gotten canned, but these ones didn't. Here are the nominees for screenwriting fiction.
My Roommate from Hell, Episode 1, One Hell of a Night, written by Gabriel Morales. Morbuck's Leasing Office, afternoon. The leasing office looks lackluster and unpolished. There's a sign that reads, Morbuck's Apartments Roommate Mixer, 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. Looking for a roommate? Good. We're looking for money. Carlos, Henry, and Irving look worried. Henry, you said the roommate mixer started at 12. We're 2 hours late. We all know that I'm not a morning person. I did us a favor. Do I need to remind you that our roommate left and we only have 2 days to replace him? No new roommate means expensive rent. Expensive rent means no place to live. No place to live means not going to school. And not going to school means forever making 12 an hour, having no 401k, and that means I'll never move out of my uncle's house and I'll die a virgin. You think you did us a favor?
Altitude Sickness, Avoiding the Hangover, written by Alexa Marquez and Paige Riley. Interior Plain Kitchen, Day. Gabby holds a coffee pot, forehead pressed against the cabinets. Her hair is in a messy bun, and her makeup is smudged under her eyes. She starts to speak to herself in a whisper in the voice of a radio announcer.
And she does it again, folks. Gabby makes it to work on time with a level 10 hangover, and the crowd goes wild.
Chad and Brad are walking off the jetway into the plane. Brad is cute and non-threatening. Chad looks sharp and like a tool. Gabby drinks from a cup of coffee.
Dude, that's weird.
No, I swear! If my dog was turned into a woman, I would marry her!
Whoa, sweetheart. Late night?
The Neighborhood, Episode 1, Won't You Be My Neighbor? Written by Brandon Hood. Luke and Andy's house, night. Ted enters the living room filled with residents of the neighborhood, who are all puppets. They include Andy's roommate Luke, Ted's mother Layla, and Scamp the dog, who is waiting by the door chasing his own string. Ted sticks out like a sore thumb. Everyone is talking and having a great time. Layla notices a taxi cab drive up. Andy's here! Everybody hides. Barry can't find a hiding spot, so he puts a lampshade over his head. The door opens with just a silhouette showing, and everyone jumps out. Surprise! Andy, a puppet in a jumpsuit and always wearing a backpack, slowly walks into the house. The residents are going wild, playing music, throwing confetti, and yelling adoring cries to Andy. Andy's body is matted, covered with stains, has some strings out of place. He is stone-faced and looking down. Scamp excitedly trots towards Andy, and Andy recoils in fear. Don't touch me! Everyone goes silent.
Hello, it's Professor Drennan here, I think, probably. I hope you've all been enjoying this time of solitude and isolation and getting some great writing done. I know I have been. Speaking of which, I would like to congratulate the winner of this year's Becca Award for Best Fiction Script. The winner is Gabriel Morales, my roommate from the house, One Hell of a Night.
Okay. Thank you so much. This script was inspired by my fourth year in college, my living experience. I really didn't have the greatest time. Like, it was so bad. Like, my roommate was literally something from hell. So I wanted to incorporate that into the script. And then, yeah, just thank you so much to Professor Drennan, to who else? Mary Smith, Jet Jacoby, Kathleen Skillicorn, Yumi Wilson. Who else did I have as a teacher? Jeff Jacoby, I already said him. Len Haynes. Just thank you all so much for believing in me.
These are the individuals I interviewed when making my documentary. Hello, everyone. How are you doing?
Hey, how's it going? School closing, BECAfest getting canceled. I don't really care. I mean, I'm just ready to move on with my life, if I'm being quite honest.
Hey. I don't know, like, I've been better. Do you think that I'm ever gonna hear Dr. Clemens say he'll cut me ever again? Do you guys think we're gonna go back in the fall? I need to go back?
You know what, guys? I'm at peace. I really hated all of my classes.
Hey, thanks for having me. Yeah, I haven't been to school in like 2 months, and I don't really know what's going on. I'm kind of just really confused. School's closed, nothing's running. Apparently we're in quarantine, but I just don't know what's going on. I'm just really, really confused, and I actually thought that you could fill me in.
After conducting my research, I noticed a new development in the story that I wanted to explore with you next. Introducing the nominees for Best Nonfiction Script.
The One Where I Thought I Was Going to Die by Bailey Zuck. Hi, welcome. Have a seat. Today, I'm going to tell the story of the time I thought I was going to die. It all started as a normal day, but unexpectedly, I felt a sharp pain go through my chest. I waved it off, assuming it was nothing. But as the days went on, the pain persisted. It would come and go, but it began lasting longer and longer, until eventually the pain sat in my chest from the time I woke up to the time I went to sleep. By the fourth day, I began having shortness of breath, shakes, and headaches. I couldn't eat, I couldn't sleep. My anxiety had convinced me I was going to have a heart attack at 21 years old.
Burrito Bobby by Amber Granite.
After moving to Seoul, South Korea at 19 years old, I was living the dream. I could drink legally, eat spicy rice cakes and fish cake all day long. Whenever I wanted, I would hop on the subway with the hottest song of the year, Love Scenario by K-pop group Icon, blasting in my ears. Order kimchi fried rice, chicken, red bean pancakes, you name it. I had it all. Music, food I could never get sick of, coffee, everything. Except for a roommate I could live in peace with. Every single day since I had landed in Seoul, my roommate had a new complaint. The food was too spicy, nobody sells burgers, there weren't enough pictures on the menu for people who couldn't read, and the biggest grievance of them all was that not a single place in all of Seoul sold a good burrito. One particular Monday, my roommate was non-stop ranting about how much she missed Anchor Intro. A professor at San Francisco State University is working on a new bilingual Spanish journalism curriculum set to begin in 2020. Here is Jennifer Rios with the story. San Francisco State Journalism Professor Lourdes Cardenas is in the process of building a new bilingual journalism program on campus. Professor Cardenas says the program will teach students writing and reporting in the Spanish language. Our idea is to create a bilingual journalism sequence in our department. I want to develop this program that is going to prepare students well. It is going to give them opportunities to develop their skills as journalists, in the way that Americans you know have good journalism. Cardenas currently teaches writing and journalism classes here at San Francisco State. She believes it's time for students to combine the skills and knowledge of journalism and bring that to.
Hello, I'm Professor Chiyoung Cha. I'm visiting the Simpson family. Where is Marge? Let me announce this award. The winning show in script, best nonfiction is Frito Bobby. Congratulations.
Thank you. I just want to thank Professor Drennan for giving us this assignment and for my friends for reminding me that I had this crazy story to talk about. So, yeah. Also, thank you for nominating me and to all the other nominees. I think all of your scripts were really great and amazing. Yeah, thanks.
Okay, guys, we just got selected to do Faculty Choice for BECAfest. What are we going to do?
I don't want to do it. I want to go back to bed.
Okay, but we have to do it.
I don't care.
Edwin, we all want to go to bed right now, but come on. We got to figure out something or else Jeff's going to kill us.
Let him kill us. We're already about to die anyways. The world is ending. Cats and dogs living together. Mass hysteria.
Okay, calm yourself there, bud. Who even are the judges?
I think Elaine is one of them. Maybe Connie, Kamacha, Jeff, Becca faculty, you know?
Probably Clemens is in it too. Just add a laugh track to it. Then he'll probably pick that one. First of all, like, who is faculty going to choose anyways? I mean, we're in the middle of a pandemic. Do you even think people, like, turned in things or something?
That's true. You all know they're going to look for different things.
Yeah, especially since Becca's students. We are very creative people, and all of us deserve a Becky.
Hello. I'm Professor Sammy Reist, Becca Department Chair. It gives me great pleasure to announce the winner of the Faculty Choice Award for BECAfest 2020. The Faculty Choice Award is given to one of the nominated projects that did not win in its category, but that the faculty feel deserves a Becky. And the winner is La La Land. May I please have the real envelope? The actual winner of this year's Faculty Choice Award is Ratchet and Crank. Congratulations!
I honestly didn't expect to win because I thought the Faculty Choice Awards was for those who won a category. But anyways, I just would like to thank you guys for choosing my project. And I also would like to thank Professor Jeff Jacoby for, you know, if it weren't for him and his class, I wouldn't be able to do the sound design project. And thank you guys so much.
What? The show's over?
Well, that was really terrific, I think. I just want to say thanks to all the students, staff, and faculty who really make this show happen. You know, in spite of all the crazy going on right now, I know that Beca will thrive. I know this because of the remarkable people in this wonderful community. So, thanks for watching BECAfest 2020. Good night, and stay well.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye.